I got it done to let them know that I'm the one. Huh? Way I ride the drum, they salute me in the slum. In the 600, the color of bubble gum. I'm with my nigga Spitz and my nigga Bun Crumb.
Before Nicki Minaj posed with her butt out on the cover of her single Anaconda, before she beefed with Mariah Carey, Iggy Azalea, Miley Cyrus, and seemingly every other lady in the biz, before she made Forbes Hip Hop Cash Kings list 4 years in a row, before she became the only woman in history to have 7 songs on the Billboard Top 100 at the same time. Nicki Minaj was born in Trinidad Tobago to a drug addicted father who tried to kill her mother in a house fire. After failing to launch a career as an actress, she worked at Red Lobster where she got fired. She was a telemarketer and worked an office job on Wall Street, but she wasn't content with the 9-to-5. She hustled hard to break into the music industry. On an early deal, she was given the name Nicki Minaj, one that she says she hates till this day. And way before Meek Mills, she had a boyfriend for 12 years who worked and lived in her shadow. I'm Azzy, documenting the life of Nicki Minaj here on Before They Were Famous. Now, Michael previously filmed a Before They Were Famous for Nicki Minaj, but this is an updated version. Be sure to let me know in the comments down below who you would like to see documented next. And you can check me out on Instagram at Azzyland. Born in Trinidad and Tobago on December 8, 1982, Nicki Minaj was born Onika Tanya Mirage. Her early years were incredibly difficult. At 5 years old, she lived with her grandmother in St. James while her parents were in New York searching for a home and employment. 2 years later, Nicki was sent to Queens to live with her parents. However, life wasn't any better. Her dad was abusive, addicted to drugs, and he even tried to set their house on fire to kill their mom. Nicki has stated in several interviews that her and her mother lived in fear for her early years, but she used this fear to make something of herself. Since a young age, Nicki had always expressed an interest in the arts. She played clarinet in school and wrote her first rap at the age of 12. She eventually went to study at LaGuardia High School, which had a strong emphasis on the performing arts and music. What was crazy, she didn't even major in singing. Nicki lost her voice on the day of the audition and ended up in the school's drama program instead.
Call Ledger right now and tell him I can have my baby back.
I am not gonna argue.
Call him!
After graduating, she wanted to be an actress and was cast in the off-Broadway play In Case You Forgot back in 2001. After her acting career failed, Nicki went to go find a job. Nicki was determined to make it in the music industry, and her first job was backup singing for New York City rappers. During one of her first production deals, her manager forced her to use the name Minaj to make her ooze sex appeal, you know, like menage a trois. She didn't like the idea of it and she fought to use the stage name, but she gave in at the end and she hates it till this day. Throughout this time, Nicki was dating a guy by the name of Safari S.B. Samuels. On top of being her lover, he was also her assistant and personal hype man. Nicki always kept their relationship under wraps and never acknowledged it, even when the two were seen with matching engagement bands. She was eventually discovered by Dirty Money CEO Fendi, who came across her MySpace page and immediately signed her to the label. After signing with Dirty Money, she collaborated with Lil Wayne on a bunch of mixtapes and gathered a following. After 3 mixtapes between 2007 and 2009, she teamed up with Kanye West on the track Monster, and Kanye later admitted in an interview that he almost cut her out of the verses. Why? Well, she was good and he was worried that she would outshine him. Nicki released their debut album in 2010 and won Best Hip Hop Female in the BET Annual Music Awards. She released her follow-up album in 2012, Pink Friday Roman Reloaded, and her most recent one, The Pink Print, in 2015. On there, the song Bed of Lies is apparently a call-out to that ex-boyfriend, SB, whose hype man services she no longer requires.
Because you don't appreciate a bad bitch.
All of these albums went platinum, and Nicki has amassed quite the collection of awards. She has won 4 AMAs, 10 BET Awards, 4 Billboard Music Awards, and hundreds of more. Nicki Minaj's high school quote is, "To survive is to stay alive in the face of opposition." Not only did she survive, but she thrived and she made her way to the top. And the rest of the story, well, you know the story, because this is Before They Were Famous. Once again, I'm Azzy. I had a blast filling in for Michael. I hope you guys enjoyed the video. Make sure to hit subscribe and watch other videos. You can also check me out on the most amazing top 5. Until next time, bye guys. Oh, and by the way, who do you guys want us to document next?